Thank you, Jürgen, for this kind introduction. So welcome everybody to this presentation on applicants' names and non-patent literature. Now, the aim of this presentation is to show you why it is important for us examiners to search non-patent literature of Asian applicants and inventors. And I would also like to show you how you can find NPL of Chinese applicant, even if you're not fluent in Chinese. Now, just a short background information. So NPL, so non-patent literature, includes everything that is not patent. So that means journal publication, conference proceedings, but also traditional knowledge and PhD thesis. And because of all those different formats, it's much more difficult to search NPL because it's not grouped in one database, as it's the case with patent, but it's in several databases and often also in different databases according to the country of origin. So now, why is it important to search non-patent literature, NPL of Asian applicant? Well, the reason is that there is a very strong link between patents and NPL in Asia. So the underlying reasons, for example, are national IP strategies. Public research institutes and universities are among the top filers in Asia. And reasons for this are, for example, the novelty grace period in Japan and also in China, which means that researchers can first do a journal publication and only afterwards file a patent application without losing novelty. Then there is a provisional filing system in Korea. Universities are often exempted from annual fees, and funds for research can be attributed according to the number of patent applications or the number of granted patents. And what is more is that there is a very high degree of cooperation between companies and research institutes, and they can be both explicitly mentioned on the patent application, but they can also be tacit. That means that they are not really mentioned. Here, this graph shows you the network of cooperation between Chinese academic organizations and Chinese industrial organizations. And as you can see, it is very dense. In the following, when I talk about China, I always refer to the People's Republic of China. So all in all, it is very important to search NPL published by inventor of patent applications from Asia. Now, how can I find NPL of Chinese applicants if I'm not fluent in Chinese? Now, a very good tool to do this is Baidu Academic. So Baidu is the Chinese equivalent to Google, and Baidu Academic then the equivalent to Google Scholar. Baidu Academic is only available in Chinese, but by using a translation extension of your browser, such as in this example here, I used Google Translate, it is still very easy to use the page. Now, if I want to search NPL publications of an inventor, I have to use the Chinese script. Now, why is it important to search the original script, so the Chinese script of inventors from China? The reason is that different Chinese names may be transliterated into the same Latin form. So in this example here, you see five Chinese names that some of them resemble a bit, some of them don't resemble at all. But they are all transliterated into the Latin script Huang Shudong, which means if I would search for publications from Huang Shudong in Latin script, I would get results from all those five names. So this means a lot of noise. So therefore, I have to use the Chinese script. Now, where can I find the names of applicants or inventors in the original script? A very handy tool is ESPASNet for this aim. So in ESPASNet, if you have a patent application and you look at the inventors, you have next to the inventors a small plus. And if you click on this plus, you toggle the original names. This then shows you the inventor's names in the original script, so in this case, in the Chinese script. And what I did in this example here, I copied the name of the inventor Chuao Guachun, and then I pasted it into Baidu Academic. Then to start the search, click on the blue icon. And Baidu Academic then shows you the researchers with this name found together with their affiliated academic institutions. And by clicking of one of the names, you will then find the next page here. In these examples, since the patent application related to microbiology, I choose to click on the researcher affiliated to a university with a biology department. So if you then click on the name, you get to a page where you can see the cooperation partners of the researchers, but also the affiliated academic institutions and a list of publications of the researchers. So in the present case, the inventor Zhao Guoqun of the patent application of a Chinese company is actually also a researcher working at the Chinese university. And when you look through the journal publications of this researcher, you will see that there was one journal publication on a very similar subject matter published in the same years as this patent application was filed, which means that this journal publication could have been very important for assessing novelty and inventive step. And this brings me already to the end of my presentation. So what I would like you to remember is that in Asia, there's a very strong link between applicant and inventors of patent applications on the one hand, and also of NPL. There is a high amount of scientific collaborations between university of companies, and those are not always explicitly stated in patent applications. So it is really important that you check for NPL publications by inventor of Asian patent applications. And when searching for Chinese inventors, please use the Chinese script for avoiding noise. Thank you very much for your attention. If you have further questions, then I will be there for you in the question and answer session. For questions later, feel free to email either to me or to asiainfo@epo.org. Thank you very much.